The 9/11 attacks were a wake-up call, not only to the danger of global terrorism, but to the danger of nuclear terrorism in particular. Osama bin Laden had earlier said that he felt it was the duty of all Muslims to try to create a nuclear weapon, and that threat was taken far more seriously after the attacks of 9/11. Khalid Sheikh Mohammed admitted that 9/11 attackers had considered in their planning the option of attacking a U.S. nuclear reactor to try to create a Chernobyl-type event. That threat was taken far more seriously. And after 9/11, in the decades since, the United States and many others have significantly degraded the capability of al-Qaeda, both attacking, killing, and capturing leadership and damaging the organization. And as Steve mentioned, there's been significant, although not complete, lockup of nuclear materials. But we recognized in our Global Nuclear Futures Project that one of the most difficult, often hidden dangers is the danger of an insider threat, that an individual of malicious intent or coerced or someone inadvertently could do something on inside a nuclear facility that could encourage sabotage, create a vulnerability, or help a terrorist attack. And what we have done is to gather together a remarkably diverse and experienced set of people, from senior military commanders, psychiatrists, biologists, nuclear specialists from the Department of Energy and the labs, and political scientists and historians, to address these problems, with the principle being that we should not only learn from our mistakes that we've made in the past, but also learn what I call vicarious learning, learn from other people's mistakes, how we can learn not just from our own problems, but from other people's mistakes. And I'm going to be introducing four of the specialists with whom we have been meeting and who are writing papers in this project, and have each of them speak briefly about their work and some of the lessons that they've been learning. First, and you have all of this in your brochure, so I will not read exactly what's in there, but just add a few extra points. Thomas Heghammer is Director of Terrorism Research at the Norwegian Defense Research Establishment. Is considered one of the world's absolute top specialists in al-Qaeda, and is the author of Jihad in Saudi Arabia. He'll be talking about his work on the threat side in this particular area. Our second speaker will be Paul Stockton. Dr. Stockton is a managing director of SONACOM. Before joining SONACOM, he served as the Assistant Secretary of Defense for Homeland Defense and America's Security Affairs in the Obama administration. Prior to that, he was a professor at the Naval Postgraduate School, worked on Capitol Hill, and was a senior research scholar at CSAC at Stanford. He was very recently appointed to co-chair the independent review of the Washington Navy Yard shootings, an insider threat problem, and their report has just been published. Our third speaker is Jessica Stern, a fellow at the FXB Center for Health and Human Rights and a lecturer in government here at Harvard. She's the author of many books, Denial, A Memoir of Terror, Terror in the Name of God, and The Ultimate Terrorists. She also has worked in the National Security Council and in the U.S. laboratories at Livermore National Laboratory, and has been doing research in this project on the anthrax attacks and why we didn't see an insider as posing as much of a threat as we clearly should have. And last speaker is Matt Bunn. Matt's professor of practice at Harvard's Kennedy School, has written widely on questions of nuclear security, producing numerous annual reviews of the global nuclear security progress and lack of progress in other areas. Most recently, wrote a technical report called Transforming U.S. Energy Innovation, has been a wonderful partner in setting up this particular part of the Global Nuclear Future Initiative with me, and we have together co-authored very recently a Worst Practices Guide to Insider Threats, Lessons from Past Mistakes. There are many best practices guides about how to do things better but we thought it would be useful to remind people of how often people make very bad mistakes in this area and illustrate that with real events that should have been prevented and were not, and we tried to explain why that's the case. Let me turn it over to you, Thomas.